็พี่รถเล็กก็เป็นมวยประเภทบู๊ดุดันครับเตะขาต่อยหมัด
คิดวิเคราะห์กุหลาบดำมวยซ้ายที่หนักครับที่แบบชนะน็อกเขามาเรื่อยๆคือหมัดซ้ายหนักนะครับ
อาวุธที่หนักหน่วงของแกก็มีเตะขาต่อยหมัดฟันศอกครับก็อาวุธที่น่ากลัวนะน่าที่ว่าต้องระวังอะครับ
คือเน้นสนุกสนานไปก่อนแต่เราอย่าประมาทโดยที่แบบเราก็ต้องป้องกันหมัดเขาได้เหมือนกันซึ่งผมคิดว่าถ้าเราป้องกันได้โอกาสชนะมันก็สูงนะครับลูกเกมมีก็คือเดินไปเรื่อยเดินชวนออกอาวุธอะไรไปเรื่อยถ้าแต่เราก็ต้องระมัดระวังหมัดเขานั่นนะครับที่สำคัญ
ใครพลาดก็ร่วงครับมีสิทธิ์ร่วงทั้งคู่ครับอาจมีสิทธิ์ไม่ครบยกครับคู่นี้ครับ
ไม่ได้มีอะไรมากครับมีแต่หมัดที่แบบเด่นกว่าอันอื่นแต่ผมครับเมื่อคิดว่าที่เหนือกว่าจะเป็นหนึ่งก็คือแบบอาวุธน่าจะเยอะกว่านะครับแล้วก็เรามันมีแบบใจน่าจะเหนือกว่านิด
Rodlek, known by one of the best nicknames in the sport, the Steel Locomotive, against the Hitman, Liam Harrison. Good outside thigh kick to start off there from Harrison. In a 110 match career, Harrison only ever been defeated once with a headshot knockout. That is an amazing achievement. Good outside the kick again.
You can definitely see the speed differential between these two when they throw their leg kicks. You can see how Rodlek kind of turns his hip over, but Liam Harrison just kind of throws that snappy leg kick.
Oh, the combination! Rapid fire there from Rodlek. That was beautifully done. Four punch combination followed by the exclamation mark with the leg kick. 4 ounce gloves in a Muay Thai contest, 3x3. No room for feeling out. You've got to go hard and fast under these one super series Muay Thai rules. It's all about action. And we're seeing plenty of it so far in the first round. Good stiff jab there from Rodlek. Outside leg kick again from Harrison. Rodlek needs to start checking those. Goes to the inside leg, hoping that femur profunda. Then goes to the common peroneal nerve above the left knee of Harrison. Left hand again. That lead hand, a trip hammer for Rodlek. Harrison probing. Outside leg kick from the Brit. Nice high guard here from Liam Harrison. On the outside, Rodlek controlling center ring. Long reaching jab from Harrison. Jab, body shot, step through knee attempt from Rodlek. I love the combination so far from Rodlek, PK, Saenchai, Muaythaigym.
Yeah, when he's not throwing just one shot, when he's not just throwing that leg kick, you start to see him put those combinations together. Right now, Liam Harrison's only throwing one shot, but it's also starting to do a little bit of damage. You can start to see that left leg welt up there on Rodlek. But when Rodlek puts those combinations together, man, it's something special.
Three judges ringside are scoring this on a 10-point must system. So if you're scoring at home, or if you're watching in 140-plus countries around the world, you score 10 points for the winner of the round, 9 points for the less dominant athlete of the round. Oh, a high kick from Harrison, and that went agonizingly close. That was fast. That was lightning fast. And then down to the leg kick from Harrison.
Harrison's definitely got that speed advantage.
Harrison relying on the single shots. Rodlek with the combinations in the opening round. Another combination string there from Rodlek. Uppercut elbow. Leg kick from Rodlek. Body shot to an outside leg kick from Harrison. That's the combo from the man from the UK. The hitman smiles at him. Oh, he has tenderized that lead quadriceps of Rodlek, PK, Saenchai, Muaythaigym.
Oh, nice. Look at that four-piece combination there thrown by Rodlek as he goes one, two, three, and then finishes with that leg kick. Beautiful combination work there.
Two men who between them hold 11 world titles. Two of over 130 martial arts world champions in one championship. Jab from Harrison. There's the outside thigh kick. Three in a row. How do you do a hat trick from Harrison?
Yeah, this is what we think was going to happen. There's doubled up on it.
dragon. That leg kick is an absolute house on fire. Faster than a speeding ticket for Liam Harrison.
No, we don't give speeding tickets to athletes here, but Liam Harrison might need one there. We wanted combination work. But he sold combination work with just one shot.
And you know Rodlek's a little frustrated because he smiles at Harrison, which means Harrison's connecting. Harrison's hurting him. It's beautiful legwork from Liam Harrison. Oh, the left hook there from the Brit. Oh, connected with the right hand, and Harrison goes down. A single right hand from Rodlek to the jaw. And the third count on Harrison. And how the tide turned so quickly on a dial in the sport of Muay Thai.
Just like that, he turned those knuckles over and put him down with that jab. You can see how Rodlek's changing that guard. He's moving back and forth between southpaw and orthodox. Here come the leg kicks.
Has Harrison recovered? The leg kicks are not slowing down the hands of Rodlek, which is amazing considering the punishment that lead leg has taken. And here come the combinations of Rodlek again. He calls Harrison forward. The crowd is eating it up. They're loving every moment of one Super Series Muay Thai. Harrison with the left hook, smack bang on the kisser. Outside leg kick from Rodlek. Combination work from Harrison. This one's a match of attrition. This one's a beauty. To an up and up, one championship legendary quest. Harrison glances towards his corner. He's on the outside again. Drifts off to his right. Away from the power side of Rodlek. Rodlek stepped through knee, hope for the liver section. Under a minute to go, Dragon.
You start to see Rodlek just trying to find a home for that big right hand of his, and as he's setting it up with the stance changes, when he switches to orthodox, you know that right hand is coming. Harrison's got to be careful when he starts throwing those leg kicks in his open up with that right hand.
The confidence on Rodlek PK.Saenchai Muaythaigym is oozing out of every pore. A second knockdown there on Liam Harrison.
I think Harrison kind of knocked himself down there. He threw that right hand so hard that he spun around himself and lost his balance. Oh, big right hand.
That uppercut almost took out the ceiling lights. Leg goes downstairs to Harrison. Goes a little higher on that occasion. It's been a bad round for Harrison. It's been a great round for Rodlek, who pulls him on. The three-time world champion, Rodlek, owns the round.
There it is. There was that right hand that just touched the top of the temple there.
Mitch, you can see why they call Rodlek the steel locomotive, because he's continually coming forward. Both men are masters at it. They hold 11 world titles between them. Has been Rodlek's contest so far. After a good first round from Harrison, twice in the second, a lot of ground to cover, and that's how he may do it. The rapid fire handiwork from Liam Harrison.
They're testing each other's chins, so they're coming down to who can read the punches the best.
Harrison needs to knock down Rodlek. Rodlek flowing with confidence. The steel locomotive comes forward again, adjusts his tracks, tries to clinch up with Harrison. Little slip there.
Go!
Even when Rodlek switches to that southpaw stance, Harrison's still trying to go across the body, still attack that leg.
Chopping leg kicks again, a shade of blue and purple on that left leg of Rodlek. Right hand from Harrison. Good check there from Rodlek, smiles at Harrison.
Harrison knows he's hurting him with that leg kick.
That's why Rodlek is switching stance between southpaw and orthodox. The southpaw will protect the lead leg. That being the left leg, it'll switch it to the back, make it the rear. Good cracking right hand there from Harrison. This has been an absolute beauty. This has been Muay Thai 101. Another big leg kick for the left leg. The handiwork from Harrison goes to the shin. A little bit of showboating from Rodlek, the entertainer, the three-time world champion.
Yeah, and right there, Harrison should have lit him up when he had his hands posed in the air, thinking he was Karate Kid.
Oh, oh leg kick! Here comes Harrison! Here comes the hitman! And he can't drop it! He stunned it, but he can't drop it!
Wobbled him a little bit. It's there, this is Harrison's round. If he wants to take it with him, he needs a knockdown, though.
No doubt about it, Harrison's round so far, just over a minute remaining.
Go!
Both men exchanging heavy leather in four-hour Rodlek's gloves. Good check there from Rodlek. Smiles at Harrison. Harrison doesn't smile back. He's concentrating, looking for an opening, looking for a chink in the armor of Rodlek. Something that may drop Rodlek PK.Saenchai Muaythaigym.
You can see just how accurate Liam Harrison is. When Rodlek tries to cover up, he's able to cut right through that and find that hole.
25 seconds remains. Can Harrison find a knockdown? More combinations than a bent set, but still he cannot drop Rodlek. A flying elbow from Harrison. He cuts Rodlek with that one, and Rodlek said, is that all you've got? You've got to do more than that. This has been one of the greatest one Super Series contests we've seen.
You know, Rodlek might be showing us that these shots don't hurt him, but they are scoring on him. And he opened him up bad, Michael. Superman elbow, that's what lit him up right there and opened up Rodlek. Nice little slapping right hook there by Rodlek. As he tries to skip it, and that was the shot. That was that Superman elbow that split him open.
By unanimous decision from the red corner, Rodlek PK.Saenchai Muaythaigym.
Man, Hobo Sako is a gigantic bantamweight.
Jabs early. Southpaw starts on both these men. Jab from Saka. Inside leg kick from Bobo Saka. Nice jab from Sacco, checks the low kick. Good long reach here from Bobo Saka. Outside leg kick from Kulabdam. Built like an absolute powerhouse is Kulabdam. Kicks the lead leg, high on the thigh. And again, choosing one spot. He's going to try and deaden that leg. Kicks the leg once more. Flurry on the inside there from Kulabdam. Saka, long reaching jab. Kulabdam continues to hit the leg. One way to slow down the punches of your opponent is to take out his legs.
You can see the way Bobo Saka is kind of overextending on his punches because he's having to punch down to Kulabdam. And Kulabdam loves to time that overhand left. It'll be interesting to watch how this match progresses with that left hand of Kulabdam's.
You can't move your feet, you cannot box properly. Both men wearing the Prajet armbands around their biceps. Nice two-punch combination from Kulabdam. Big outside leg kick from Uthai. Short right hand there from Sacco.
The jab of Sacco starting to land.
Lacking really has been. You want to connect though with the front of the shin rather than the slap of the instep. Jab two from Sacco. Outside leg kick from Kulabdam. Off the ropes now. Saka, nice leg kick that time. Turned it around the sciatic nerve. Kulabdam comes in with such a big reputation. 7 knockouts in a row at Channel 7 Stadium in Thailand. Almost unheard of. Nice turning right hand there from Kulabdam. Snappy jab from Saka.
Sako is starting to step out. He has these little steps that he does. He's trying to cut the corner when he turns out to the right. But Kulabdam is timing it. He's connecting with his leg kicks and overhand left.
That's why they call him the left meteorite. And the meteorite crash on the face of Bobo Saka. Saka ties him up. Kulabdam drops his punch.
Sako's got to slow this down. We're going to get a minute break here in a minute.
High kick from Bobo.
Watch this. Look at that. Just right on the top of the head. Landed beautifully there by Kulabdam. And that wobble, that was a delayed reaction. It slowly sunk in. And then the leg started to give way. And then he caught him again.
Kulabdam Kulabdam, full of confidence, Mitch.
He's got to be careful stepping off to that right. He does that a lot. I've seen it from a lot of his past fights. He likes to throw, step off to the right. Kulabdam's timed it. Catches him again with that left hand.
Kulabdam, Baraki. And Bobo Saka, look at him saying, come on, what have you got? Let's bring it. Torching, baiting, Bobo Saka. Getting inside the Frenchman's head. Playing physical and psychological games. Nice knee there from Bobo Saka. Kulabdam. A young man of such massive power and technique.
Good adjustments on the footwork from Sacco. He's not stepping off like that. He's also utilizing that jab.
Ooh, that left hook just wrapping towards the jaw of Bobo Saka. Sacco with a great time. Look at him! Try to pull the head down for the meeting break.
Oh, smiles at him. There's that left hand again. He's swinging a sock full of rocks at the face of Saka.
Saka should try and watch that knee again. The way of leverage, he does just that. Pulling the opponent down while driving the knee up to deliver up to 2.5 tons of force. Enough to lift a car. Incredible if he can latch on and pull the head down.
Stop! It's all right. Hey, be careful, yeah? Careful what you need.
Hearing strike.
Box!
Bobo Saka needs to get up first here. Outside leg kick from the Frenchman. Tried to double up on it. Ooh, there's the clinch from Bobo. That's how he's changed the game plan now. It's not about distance. It's about getting on the inside and clinching up with Kulabdam. Maybe his corner believes there now and has the upper hand in the clinch with the elbows and the knees.
Good uppercut to straight left hand combination landed by Sacco.
Saka, left to it.
Stop, right.
Referee Deluxe breaks them. 20 second remains. Second round of three. Slow round this from Kulabdam. Up the explosiveness of the first stanza. Comes forward now the top. You see the Muay Thai stance, the elbows flared out. Arms turned out to catch the kicks on the forearms, catch the elbows. Hurry away the jabs.
Stop!
Jab two, nice to down from Bobo Saka.
Sacco's starting to move that range now. He's starting to find a home for that left hand.
Good hand down from Kulabdam. This went through the ground in front of him. Toe to toe here in the third round. Jab again from Saka. Eventually the rhythm's going to get you, and it's getting pulled down so far here in the third. Bobo Saka teeing off on him. Nice jab from the Frenchman. Really let him off the ropes. Keeps him there. Low kick, uppercut. Well threaded from Saka. Saka's corner are going off their rockets. Barking instructions at the end. Double forearms guard from Kulabdam. Saka, oh, power through the lockdown! Nicely done from Bobo Saka. It's been all one-way traffic. It's been all the Frenchman here in the third round.
Yeah, he's had a much better round here in the third. He's really starting to turn it on. Kulabdam has slowed, and Bobo Saka has turned it on.
Listen!
1:05 remaining. Saka on the front foot. Kulabdam showing nowhere near the power. Stop! Of the ferocity. head in the first or the second.
He landed with that left hand though.
Shankar ties him up, throws the knees. Knee guard put on by Kulabdam. Definitely Sacco's round so far. Don't know too much French, but I know that Ale means go. I want Sacco to go. I want to go get some Kulabdam for the final 30 seconds. Another game there for the time.
Down two rounds, so he's got to end it in this one, Michael.
Two world champions in the ring. Sacco to front kick.
Nice push kick by Kulabdam.
Right.
Come on. Referee collapses, breaks him.
Sacco waits forward. Has he got one big salvo remaining? Oh, beautifully cutting kick to the midsection there from Kulabdam. Five, the left medium right. And that is the end of the round. Good. We are going down the judges' drag in the billboards.
He was able to do so much good work, especially when he got Kulabdam against the ropes here. Look at him. Boom. Two punches land. Three, four, five. All connected.
By unanimous decision from the red corner.
From Scotland versus the man they call the steel locomotive from Thailand. Kick Kiguli from the Mad Dog.
How is Mad Dog going to utilize that reach advantage? Says that jab is going to be it. He's got to use a lot of that push kick. Keep that distance. Do not allow Rodlek to get close into that range and start throwing those hands.
Rodlek, a two-time world champion, one of over 140 martial arts world champions on the one championship roster. Tucks the chin, looks through the brow, wearing 4 ounce gloves here. There is no room for error. Right, left roundhouse kick there from Mad Dog Miller. Towering Scotsman, some 12 centimeters taller in the steel locomotive. Catch and sweep there from Mad Dog Miller.
Go!
Miller might have held onto that leg a little bit longer than he's supposed to. He got a nice before he throw the hands.
And Rodlek trying to return the favor there. Jab from Rodlek against Liam Harrison. We saw the handiwork, we saw the superb leg kicks of the steel locomotive. Clean jab, dead center of the ring. Referee Onari breaks it.
Got to be active inside the clinch. You can clinch for as long as you want, but you have to be active. You have to be throwing elbows and knees and punches and kicks. You have to be moving inside that clinch.
Nice stiff jab there from Mad Dog Miller, then goes down to the sternum of Rodlek. As all ties do, Rodlek takes his last name from his gym name, hence he's called Rodlek PK Saenchai Muaythaigym.
Go!
Front kick there was more of a punt kick from Mad Dog Miller. Almost got countered with the right hand from Rodlek. On the outside here, the Mad Dog. Rodlek controlling centering. Brings those hands up again. Overhand right, leaping left hook. Maybe some options against the taller opponent here for Rodlek.
Slowly inching forward. Rodlek's trying to gauge that distance. Very patient here in the first round. Not going heavy with anything. This is Miller's chance to kind of jump on Rodlek, hurt him with those small gloves.
Rodlek's amazing record, 126 wins, 40 losses and 5 draws. A two-time world champion. Mad Dog Miller, the Scottish champion and the British super welterweight champion. 34 wins for Mad Dog Miller. Good outside leg kick from the Scotsman.
Stop!
Rodlek is actually the idol of our title contender tonight, Rodtang. Since similar names, similar styles. Rodlek's been around a lot longer than Rodtang has. Rodtang's a little bit more well-known here in one Super Series because he's done, put on such amazing performances.
Go!
Dropping down the bread basket, Rodlek quickly gets back to centering. Catch and counter, perhaps. No, just missing with the right hand. Luckily for Andrew Miller, he took a little slip to the canvas to avoid that right. Got to keep Rodlek at bay, use the jabs, stick out the push kicks to the midsection, and then when he's ready, when he sees an opening, come flying through with those knees. And also with those elbows. Here are the knees now from Mad Dog Miller.
Rodlek's starting to hammer it with those leg kicks. He's looking for him to go hands. and then start to hammer on those legs, really slow his opponent down with those leg kicks.
Good kick to the outside and inside lead thigh from the steel locomotive. Has Andrew Miller on the outside again. Miller evades the left hook. You see Rodlek quickly skips across to his left to cut off the ring movement. Go to the outside lead thigh. Miller clinches up with him. A chance for the knees for the Scotsman. Throws one to the waist. And referee, oh no, he breaks them. Rodlek goes to the legs again. Turn around, double forearms guard. Pumping the jab in the face there, Andrew Miller. Circles off to his right. Trying to stay away from the power side of the steel locomotive.
Good timing there by Miller. Rodlek spun around. Miller threw that right high kick, caught Rodlek a little bit on the chin there, a little bit more oomph into him, pushed up forward a little bit more, put that shin in. Might have been able to sleep him. Good job by Miller on that timing.
Andrew Miller's got to start checking the leg kicks. Already the outside and inside lead thigh of Miller looks like it's been sunburned. It's reddened already. And Rodlek will continue to hit that target, that common peroneal nerve just above the lead knee, which effectively deadens the leg. And Rodlek will hit it over and over again. And this time he's kneeing at the same spot over and over and over again till he deadens that lead leg of the Mad Dog.
Go! So he's trying to get inside that clinch. Let's see what, I'm not seeing those jabs. I'm not seeing those push kicks. Miller can't stand there, cover up like that, and allow Rodlek to tee off on him. Good job tying up the clinch, slowing down those hands.
Miller's got to use the reach advantage, not allow Rodlek into punching range nor into kicking range. Keep him at bay, wait for the opening, then attack. And again, Rodlek gets on the inside, throws a heavy kick to the lead thigh. There's one to the back leg of Andrew Miller. You see the reddening on the thighs there of the Scotsman. And Rodlek immediately closes down the movement. Uppercut elbow there from Andrew Miller. Rodlek goes to the body. Then the uppercut elbow from the tie. The steel locomotive is on song here in the second round. Knees from both men in the clinch. And referee Onari wanted to see more action.
Like how he's setting up those body shots, peppering him with the jab, and then stepping in deep with those heavy body shots.
Look how Rodlek cuts off the movement again. Pulls the arrow. Pulls the arrow on Andrew Miller. And he clinches with it. Pulls him in close, and there's no chance to use the knees from Rodlek. Good defensive work there from the Mad Dog.
Go!
You often see the arrow pulled when they do the pre-match Muay crew round Muay. You often see it employed actually during the round.
But we're seeing Rodlek. Here he is. He goes high, spins with the leg kick. A little bit too high as he's coming around. Miller touches him on the chin with that shin. Wobbled him a little bit. Look at that beautiful evasion there of the leg kick.
Inside leg kick from Rodlek. Left hook to right hand. Miller ties him up, pinches him against the ropes. Close the knees. Not really connecting though with a point of the knee there. Mad Dog Miller and referee Onari keeps it clean. Rodlek skips forward. Look for the power side, the right side. It's a short popping overhand right there from Rodlek.
Miller's doing a good job of shutting down the hands of Rodlek by initiating that clinch. He did it again right there. As Rodlek starts to flurry, that's the reach advantage that Miller has. Miller's able to kind of spread his arms out, clinch on, shut down the arms, and draw him in.
Oh, smack bang! He caught him with a short right hand! Smack bang to the kisser! Andrew Miller's down! He's on rubber legs, he's doing the chicken dance!
It was a beautifully timed right hand from Rodlek. He was finding his way right throughout. That's what happens. Look, Miller steps in. Look at this, short right hand, boom, right to the chin. Beautiful, drops Miller down to one knee. He wobbles back up. Look at that, beautifully timed. Look at this as he comes in.
That's the sort of right hand, Mitch, that isn't about power, that's about precision and accuracy. The exquisite technique. The man who won the Lumpini and Rajdhaman championships when he was only 16 years old. Three division champion of Rajdhaman. Lumpini champion, Omnoi Stadium champion, S1 world champion Sangmanin in Kulabdam. The 2018 Lumpini champion at 135 pounds. 2019 Lumpini champion at 140 pounds.
Sports Writers of Thailand Fighter of the Year Award. It's like winning the MVP award in the NBA or the Ballon d'Or in football. Well, Kulabdam won it in 2017. And here they are for the right to move through in this four-man bantamweight tournament and face Semipet Fairtex. Roundhouse kick there from Kulabdam. Nice jab from Sangmini, the 23-year-old. 101 wins in 132 outings. Some say Sangmini is the greatest of this modern era of the last few years. He's beaten the likes of Pumpayak Chitwangdon, Rafi Bowie, Yodpanamrun Chitwangdon, Muang Thai, Marlon Santos, Superlek Kepulkau. The list goes on for the million-dollar baby. And it's no surprise that Kulabdam, over the last 3 years, has been one of the highest-earning Thai stars in the Thai stadiums. Won his one Super Series debut in a great match against Bobo Sacco in Vietnam in September. 5-5 in his last 10, 4-1 in his last 5, Kulabdam. Sangmini, 8-2 in his last 10, 2-0 in one Super Series. That beautiful, exquisite, Muay Femur style of Sangmini. Nice jab there. Southpaw stance on both these athletes. Sangmini, who began training in Muay Thai as a 6-year-old, also competed for the first time at that age. There was such excitement in the Muay Thai community around the world when last year Sangmini signed for one Super Series. Oh, how about that though? He gets knocked out! Knocks out Sangmini with one punch! The uppercut misses, the left hand, the cross, planted him like a tree. Shocked. Absolutely shocked. I have never seen Sangmini get knocked out like that. That is unbelievable. A one-punch knockout. They will be showing this on highlight reels for years, for decades to come. Planted him, flush to the jaw. Sangmini was out. He was astral traveling before he even hit the canvas. Open the bridge.
Shaw cannot allow the steel locomotive Rodlek to set his rhythm here. Double jab from the Scotsman early. Looks for the downward elbow. They're in the 4 ounce gloves. One Super Series now, differentiating. All kickboxing matches will be in regular gloves. All Muay Thai matches will be in 4 ounce gloves. Nice popping left hand there from Shaw Dragon.
Yeah, Shaw's trying to keep that distance, but he likes to punch. He likes to close that distance and get inside Rodlek's punching range.
Both men trade leg kicks. Flicking question mark kick there from Shaw. The Scotsman edges forward. Southpaw stance, sitting behind the jab. High left roundhouse kick. Good front kick for the midsection there from Shaw. Rodlek trying to control center circle. Kick to the outside lead thigh. Returns the favour to Shaw. Nice jab again, switching to orthodox here now, the Scotsman. Outside leg kick from Rodlek. Triple jab, nicely done. Circling away from the power side of the steel locomotive. Body shot from Rodlek, trying to kick to the liver off that lead hand. Shaw the jab, needs a right hand or a right leg for company out of orthodox stance though. Jab again from the Scotsman, drifts off clockwise, but he's going into the power side of the steel locomotive. Jab two there from Rodlek. Shaw coming in as a huge underdog with the fans on the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, One Fantasy. 79% of fans tipping a victory for the steel locomotive. Only 21% for the Scotsman, Chris Shaw.
You can see the way Rodlek's trying to cut the angle. He's trying to use that low kick and those hooks to kind of trap Shaw in one particular position. But Shaw is actually using the circle very well, and he's moving around, not enabling himself to get trapped against that circle wall.
short, 12 centimeters taller, trying to use his reach advantage here, sitting at the end of his jab out of both southpaw and orthodox stances. Started in southpaw, he's at southpaw at the moment. Threads the jab nicely off either hand is short. There's a left cross down the tube, didn't really have any mustard behind it. Question mark kick again there, fires a left round kick, caught there by Rodlek. Good left hook off the catch from Rodlek. Overhand right from the tie, it's a jab. Just needs to power up on the number two here, that being the cross. Shaw sticks that front kick in the midsection. Because he's finding the range of the jab, he's just touching the chin with the cross. Jab round kick from Shaw. Rodlek wanted to move into a clinch, but Shaw would have none of it. Outside leg kick there from the steel locomotive. Shaw with the uppercut elbow. Threads a jab.
Stop!
Body shot jab. And Alice Velocca steps in to win the first round.
Nice little right hand landed by Rodlek there as he tries to close that distance and throw that big right kick.
It's usually the venue for many Pacquiao's boxing matches and the biggest concerts in the Philippines. It's going to be sold out. We're about 60% there at the moment. And as I said, 2 hours away from our main card. A round kick there from Chris Shaw. Overhand right counter from Rodlek. Front kicks from Rodlek. A little more aggression to open up the round for their steel locomotive. Rodlek, who had his biggest win with a 49-second KO in the third round over another Scotsman, Andrew Miller, at One Board of Heroes back in August. Can he go 2-0 against the Scots? Outside leg kick from Rodlek, just to that common peroneal nerve above the left knee of Shaw. Shaw ties him up, throws a knee. Breakman trade knees, dead center of the circle. And a dump there from Shaw was well executed.
And that's Shaw inside that clinch. He's got good redirects, good elbows inside that clinch. But also, when they're at range, you can see Rodlek starting to chew up those legs. He's landed several leg kicks. It doesn't matter what side Chris Shaw's coming from, when he comes orthodox or when he comes southpaw, Rodlek's just beating up those legs.
Rodlek, a three-time World Muay Thai champion, one of over 140 martial arts world champions on the ONE Championship roster. Nice right hand there from the steel locomotive, eats a jab, throws a leg kick, jab two, but again, no power behind the two. Oakman trade elbows, downward elbow there, trying to crack the clavicle with Chris Shaw. Crossing elbow open there for Rodlek, didn't take it, goes down to the liver section with the left hand, uppercut from Rodlek. Shaw's first time inside the ONE Super Series circle, uppercut elbow from here, crossing elbow. Upper elbow again off the lead arm from Chris Shaw.
Rodlek's starting to work that body. I like those hooks to the body, especially that left hook. It's landed a few times now. Shaw's got to be careful. Oh, that was a beautiful two-punch combination. The finish with the low kick.
Pinch and knee. Overhand elbow from Shaw. Corking knee. He tried to loop the shin around the neck of Rodlek. And the steel locomotive says, come on, get up, let's do this. Jumping knee from Shaw. Trying to mix it up. Rodlek with 127 career wins. Both men 29 years old. Chris Shaw a 56% knockout rate. It would be a major upset if Shaw knocks out the steel locomotive in Manila tonight. Uppercut elbow. Maybe a small cut on the, just below the bridge of the nose of Shaw. Locks on the clinch, chance for the knee, spins it nicely to the upper leg rib cage to close out the second of three.
Chris Shaw is choosing to engage Rodlek at close range, and that's where a lot of these kicks are coming from. Rodlek just piecing up that leg. Beautiful combinations, and I like how he's mixing up his angle. Beautifully done, even attacking the rear leg now on the leg kicks when Shaw tries to switch stances. Rodlek is just leveled up right now and he's starting to pour it on.
Uppercut elbow from Shaw, hoping to open a cut on the steel locomotive. And maybe he's done just that. There is some blood on the forehead of Rodlek. shots for the knees here.
A lot of them are coming from those close range elbow shots trying to throw. But Rodlek's doing a good job of evading a lot of them.
And you see Shaw now jabbing to the forehead of Rodlek. There's an overhand right curled nicely from the Scotsman. Uppercut elbow. Uppercut elbow again from Shaw. Try the locks on the clinch. Knees coming. Rodlek to the midsection. There's one from Shaw. He looked for a dump here, sure. He dumped the steel locomotive in the second round. I think it was the only dump of the contest so far. And Rodlek powers through. And Rodlek has slowed down here in the third. I feel drag, and it's now time for Chris Shaw to go, and he's trying to slice him up with the elbow.
Yeah, it's like those elbows started to suck the energy out of Rodlek. That was a beautiful dump right there from Rodlek, though, just as I say it. I think Shaw needs to get back inside that clinch. He's doing a good job. He's cutting him up with those elbows.
Acrobatic jumping round kick there from Chris Shaw moments ago. Gut munching knee from Rodlek. There's the elbow from Shaw. Catching counter from the steel locomotive. Time. And referee Elliot Philipsis calls time. Rodlek comes out smoking after the short break. Hooks for the head and an outside thigh kick from the steel locomotive. Chris Shaw clinches with him. Downward elbow to the ear there from Rodlek. Crossing elbow from Rodlek to the bridge of the nose. Rodlek trying to get the crowd behind in here. Both men have borne the damage from each other's elbow. It's been Muay Thai 101. Another crossing elbow from Shaw.
Shaw, he throws him from a lot of different angles too. Rodlek's just eating him, walking through him, and throwing leg kicks and punches. Oh, attacking the liver beautifully.
Rodlek's elbows are designed to induce power. The elbows of Shaw, not as powerful, but he places them looking to open up a cut on his opponent. Outside leg kick from the steel locomotive. Now looks like Chris Shaw slowed down, and he gets caught with a beautiful left hand. First knockdown of the bouts. Just as Shaw was starting to fatigue.
Eight, okay?
And the final 10 seconds were secure, a 10-8 round for the steel locomotive. A great way to finish for the triple world champion, Rodlek. And both men embrace in a show of martial arts honor and integrity.
Rodlek was able to land a beautiful two-punch combination and caught him slipping and hit him with that left hook, and Shaw crumbled to the ground, took his standing eight count, but a very entertaining matchup.
A unanimous decision from the red corner, Rodlek PK Saenchai Muaythaigym.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.